Today we're talking about the motors that come in the Spike Prime kit. There are two medium motors and one large motor, and really the only difference you need to know between them is that the large motor is larger and that it can also apply a little bit more force than the medium ones. The motors can spin either clockwise or counterclockwise when you program them, and there's a small indicator on the rotating piece of each motor that you can use to determine what angle it's at. It starts at zero and then increases as it rotates clockwise. You can attach pegs and axles to these rotating parts of the motors. The one thing to note is that the axles don't actually go all the way through, so you'll have to attach axles to both sides of the motor if you're making a robot that needs to rotate on both sides. We're gonna go over a few different commands you can use to control motors in both blocks, coding, and Python, and you can use the timestamps in the video description to jump to the part of the video that you need. Let's go ahead and start off with the blocks coding. Here we are in our block script, and at the very top you can see that there are motor icons that tell us which port they're in and what angle they're currently at, which can be really helpful information when you're trying to rotate your motor only a specific number of degrees. The blue section bubble on top is where you'll find all the blocks for your motors, and we're going to start with the run for block. Drag it onto the script, and we're also going to go into events and pick up a standard when program starts block. This motor block gives you a ton of control over your motors. For its parameters, you can select which port it's in. Mine's in A, there's another in B, but we won't control it. Whether it runs clockwise or counterclockwise, and how much you want it to run in terms of rotations, degrees, or seconds. I'm going to set mine to run for 2 seconds, but I only want it to run at half speed. To set that, I can go back to the motors bubble and pick up the block that says set speed to. We're gonna drop it above the other block that we have so that the speed of the motor is actually set before it starts running. Instead of 75, I'm going to do 50%. And once that's set, all we have to do is upload the program and watch it run. Not too bad, right? Something else you can do to have much more precise control over your motor is the go to block right here. With it, you can choose what angle you want your motor to rotate to and what direction it takes to get there. Let's say I want to run my motor to 263 degrees. I can just type that in, and I want it to take the shortest path in order to get there. We can move these out of the way and drop this one in. And you'll notice that my motor is basically at 0 degrees. It's a little bit fidgety, but pretty much. And when I upload the program and it runs, the motor will rotate counterclockwise in order to get there, because that's the shortest path and the fastest way to get to the 263 degrees. There's also a little bit of fidgeting going on, but that's fairly normal with these motors. Now you can see this kind of command being very useful when you need precise levels of control and you want your motor to end up at a very specific location. And if you want a challenge that uses these different kind of blocks, what you can do is set up a small wall or an obstacle and then use these blocks to program your motors to get as close as possible to the object without crashing into it. If you wanted to get creative, you could even use a couple sensors to help you out. If you want to control motors using Python, first make sure that motor is being imported at the very top. That way you can use the spike commands to control it. At the very top, you can also see motor icons that tell us what port our motors are in and what angle it's currently rotated to, which can be really useful information. Let's come over to the right and open up our knowledge base. We're going to scroll all the way to the bottom and click into single motors. There are other motor commands in the knowledge base, but we'll cover those in another video. When you click into the single motor, you'll see that there's an example of how to initialize it, and we can directly copy and paste this into our script. We can get rid of the things that we don't need, and if we need to, we can change what port it's in. And then farther down in the knowledge base, we see all the commands that we can use to control our motor. We're going with the basics in this video, and we're just going to focus on how to run your motors in terms of degrees, rotations, or seconds. If we click into seconds, you'll notice that the parameters at the top for this command are just seconds, how long you want your motor to run, and what speed you want it to run at. At the very bottom, there's an example we can copy, and I'm just going to copy it again and paste it straight into the script, except that I want mine to run for 2 seconds at a speed of 80. Then you can just upload your code, and there you go, it runs. Motors in general can be pretty simple, and you can just tell them to spin in different directions at different speeds, but you also have the ability to tell them exactly what position you want them to run to. Back here in the knowledge base, if we go back and we click into run to position, you can see that we can choose in our parameters exactly what degree we want it to run at. And what's really cool is that the second parameter tells you what direction you want it to take in order to get there. You can read a little bit more about this in the values section down here, but basically you can run it clockwise, counterclockwise, or you can just tell it to take the shortest path so it gets to the position you want as fast as possible. Once again, I'm gonna copy the example at the very bottom. I'm gonna paste it down here, and I'll comment this one out for the moment. I want my motor to run to 250 degrees, and I want it to take the shortest path to get there, so I'm just also going to copy the direction parameter and paste it right here so that it knows to take the shortest path. And when we upload and run this program, you'll see that it very quickly rotates the motor counterclockwise, since that's the shortest path to reach 250 degrees. If you really want to challenge yourself and go further with these commands, what you can do is set up a small obstacle and use any of these commands in any combination to get a small car or a small vehicle as close as possible to your obstacle without crashing into it. And there are a ton of different ways that you can do that. You could even go ahead and use a couple different sensors to help you out if you wanted to get a bit more creative. And finally, here's a comparison of the blocks and Python code that we use to program our motors today. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope that you learned something in this tutorial. Remember to like the video, and if you want to learn more about Spike Prime, make sure to check out our other tutorials.